anyone watches my show with anything approaching regularity can recognize I am a World War I buff of epic proportions. Today, the entire world, except us asshats in America who think there's just one world war and we put the two on the end of it for fucking style points, will observe what is in my eyes the most important military holiday on record, Armistice Day, the official demarcation point for the end of hostilities in World War I, a conflict that still holds the record for single-day fatalities wherein millions of men were mowed down by machine gun fire for all of 15 feet of fucking trenches, only to have the very same gains erased by the opposition's counter-advance within the hour. It's a conflict whose pointlessness rivals the PS classic, yet history, in the words of Napoleon, is a lie agreed upon, and perusing the articles marking the centenary of this solemn occasion, it ain't hard to spot the lie. European liberals show solidarity as alt-right movements rise in Europe. Macron cautions Europe against the rise of nationalism on Armistice Day. In fact, perusing the omnipresent stink pieces on the First World War, one word leaps repeatedly to the fore. If any of you passed even preliminary fucking high school history in America or elsewhere, you could probably distill the explanation you were given for why World War I went down to just one word. Nationalism. Oh, how those bloviating imperialist cousin fuckers in Germany and Russia catapulted us all into one of the most disastrous conflicts in human history, all because they were too prideful of their own stretch of mottled earth. When will humanity unite as one, in say a benevolent globalist cabal perhaps, and preclude this harrowing tragedy from ever being birthed anew? Yeah, a bit of a problem there, princess. Once you purge the revisionist poison your professor's power injected into your cranium, you realize nationalism was kinda caused by World War I, not the other way around. Let's make like Harvey Weinstein and do the broad strokes. Austria-Hungary, a literal combination of two countries, with several others later to be named therein, had designs on absorbing yet another country, plucky young Serbia. Now, here's where your first instance of actual nationalism occurs, but as history professors are loath to point out, it emerged only after Serbia had been incorporated, invaded, and otherwise attempted to be absorbed by everyone from Bulgaria to old Uncle Austria-Hungary himself. A Serbian underground emerges, the Black Hand. They assassinate the Archduke of Austria-Hungary as he makes the rounds in Sarajevo. The Black Hand is aided, though not run exclusively by, individuals entrenched in the Serbian military. Austria, learning this, labels it an all but officially endorsed rebellion, and recognizing at last the pretext to forcibly globalize Serbia, declares war on a country the size of a fucking thimble. Now, you can call that prologue informed by nationalism, but here's the thing. But for what happens next, it would have still been little more than the 15 fucking billionth Balkan War. Here's where globalism jungles us all in the ever-loving asshole. Prior to World War I, the prevailing wisdom of one world government was already in its ascent. In the wake of the Napoleonic Wars, the Crimean conflict, and every other fucking thing, the order of the day in Europe? Mutual protection pacts. Today, we call them alliances, and of course today Europe calls it the European Union. The more connected countries are with one another, so went the utter illogic in question, the less likely they will be to initiate hostilities. And so everyone shacked up with everyone the fuck else. Russia with Serbia, Germany with Austria, the Ottomans with Austria and Germany, Italy with England, Bulgaria with the Ottomans, England with Belgium, Belgium with fucking France. Boy, that's a lot of global alliances and trading partnerships. By Woodrow Wilson logic, that must have fostered the most enduring fucking peace in human history. Peace. Pieces. What's a few million dead German and French guys between fucking friends? Germany, being allied to Austria, declares war on Serbia. Russia, having a mutual protection pact with such, backs Serbia's play. France, being allied to Russia, declares war on Germany and Austria. The Ottomans, being allied to Austria, declare war on everyone that ain't Germany and Austria. And England, they get involved when Germany invades France through neutral Belgium without saying please first. Ain't alliances a joy? Nationalism didn't cause World War I. The growing pains of globalism did. Fuck, if anything, nationalism was symptomatic of it. Read Eric Marie Remarque's superb chronicle of the First World War, All Quiet on the Western Front. School teachers beating their breasts about the need for national unity, of young men going to glory in the trenches of Verdun to defend the fucking fatherland. Here's the thing about those sequences. The war was already on by then, bitch. Nationalism wasn't the catalyst for World War I. It was a handy recruitment tool after it had already butt-fucking begun. And name a time the commencement of a conflict hasn't had a nationalist aftertaste. I'll fucking wait. Aid public education indoctrination up, bitch. With Merkel and Macron circling the one world wagons as Poland, Italy, England, and the United States have suddenly located their fucking nuts again, expect further inculcation on the subject, but let not the true purpose of Armistice Day be lost. To commemorate the horrifying millions, many of whom you and I are fucking related to, that perished in the blood and mud of their respective motherlands because a shitbag swilling brandy in a palatial estate unilaterally decreed an endless procession of one world alliances were the way forward for fucking humanity. This ain't about their crusty-ass commie ideals. Fuck, it's not even about mine. It's about those brave men powering over the top of a trench to certain death. I'm Razor Fist. God bless America, and Godspeed.